Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss journal entries. In our previous classes, we have discussed few important problems of depreciation. Today we are going to discuss the most important part of accountancy, journal entries. As you all aware of the classification of accounts, in my first video I have already explained about classification of accounts. Accounts is classified into two categories. Number one is personal account and number two is impersonal account. Impersonal account again subdivided into two parts, real account and nominal account. Personal account related to persons, for example, artificial persons, natural persons, representative persons. Whereas impersonal account, which is subdivided into two categories, real account, which is related to assets. Assets also categorized into two parts, tangible assets, intangible assets. Tangible assets are those assets which we can see and touch. There is a physical existence of those assets called as tangible assets. Let us say, for example, machinery, buildings. We can see the buildings. We are able to see the machinery, plant, etc., etc., are the tangible assets. Intangible assets, goodwill, patents, trademarks, etc. So these comes under real account. And lastly, from your impersonal account, nominal accounts, all the expenses related to nominal account, all the income also comes under nominal account. Certain rules for these all three types of accounts are there, which is said to be, for personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. For real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. For nominal account, all expenses and losses, debit it. Debit all expenses and losses. Whereas, credit all incomes and gains. So, on the basis of these golden rules of accounts, we can solve the journal entry problem. Let's see how to solve these transactions. Once you look at the question here, journalize the following transactions. Mr. Ram commenced business of rupees 98,000. Here, as you can see that Mr. Ram is a person related to personal account. So, debit the receiver, credit the giver. So Mr. Ram is giving his amount to start a business, to commence a business. So who is gonna debit here? What he is giving? He is giving cash, or he is investing some cash from his own side to start a business. That is why the journal entry will be date 2019, January 1st, what comes in the business? Cash in as asset. Cash is an asset. It comes under real account. What comes in? Debit what comes in. Cash comes in. That is why we are debiting it. Cash account debited to, who is the giver here? Mr. Ram. To Mr. Ram's capital account. How much? It has mentioned in the question that 98,000. You need to write a narration here. Being business started with cash. Being business started with cash. So this is the transaction you need to write. The next question is, purchased office furniture of rupees 20,000. In each and every transaction, you can find either personal account twice or personal account real account, or sometime you'll find real account or nominal account, or sometime you'll find personal account and nominal account. The transaction based on two types of account. Now here we'll see purchased office furniture. As soon as you purchase something, your cash goes out. If you want to buy something, so you need to pay some cash. Here you are purchasing office furniture. Either you can select one type of account from this and solve this transaction, or you can go, either you can go with the real account as well as here in this transaction. Office furniture is also comes under real account, and purchases comes under nominal account. So as you purchased office furniture, so purchase has been cancelled because you know the name of asset. And how you are purchasing? By paying cash. How much cash you are paying? 20,000 rupees. So 20,000 rupees is the cost of office furniture. Office furniture comes under real account, and cash also comes under real account. So what comes in, what goes out, you need to be careful while solving this transaction. On date 4, purchased office furniture. What comes in here? Office furniture. So write on a debit side, real account rule, debit what comes in. Office furniture account debited to cash account. Office furniture account debit to cash account. Why? Because cash is going out, that is why we are crediting the cash. And what we have debited here? We have debited furniture. What comes in debit, what goes out credit is the rule of real account. So office furniture account debit to cash account. How much is the amount? 20,000. And narration, being office furniture purchased, being office furniture purchased for cash, look at the next transaction here. Purchase goods for cash 10,000 from Ramesh. As you can see here in this question, you need to understand the concept of these journal entries. With the help of classification of accounts, there are Ramesh is there. Three parts of this transaction. There are three parts of this transaction. Ramesh, cash, purchases. You don't know the name of the goods. What Ramesh has, from Ramesh, what we have purchased. So as you don't know the name of the goods, purchases goods for cash is the transaction from Ramesh. As you paid the cash, so no need to write the party name. Either you can purchase from Ramesh or you can purchase from Suresh. So purchase goods for cash rupees 10,000 from Ramesh. Then the answer for this transaction, purchases account debtor to, not Ramesh, don't write Ramesh because we have already paid the cash. So write purchase account debtor to cash account. How much? 10,000 rupees. being goods purchased for cash. Being goods purchased for cash. So what is the next transaction here? Sold goods to Akbar. The last transaction of today's problem is sold goods to Akbar. Amount 16,000. So here Akbar comes under personal account and sales is a nominal account. Take Akbar. What is the rule of personal account? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. So if you are selling, who is receiving here? Akbar is receiving. You are selling to Akbar. So Akbar account debited to sales account being goods sold on credit. How much is the amount? 16,000. Why we are not writing cash here? Because it is not mentioned the cash. The transaction is on credit. How do you know that? Look at here. Sold goods to Akbar. There is no cash involved in this transaction. Hope you understood and enjoyed today's class. Let's finish off the today's journal entries. Once you see the question, Mr. Ram commenced business with ₹98,000. Then the answer is for this journal entry will be cash account debtor to Mr. Ram's capital account being business started with cash, 98,000 debit, 98,000 credit. Purchased office furniture of ₹20,000. Office furniture, because furniture comes in, asset comes in. So what is the rule of real account? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So office furniture comes in, that is why debited office furniture account debtor to what goes out here? Cash. Office furniture account debtor to cash account 20,000. Date 7, if you can see, purchase goods for cash ₹10,000 from Ramesh. So you are purchasing goods from Ramesh, but you are paying the cash. As soon as you paid the cash, no need to write the name of from where you are buying. From no need to write the name of the party. So from whom you are buying? Ramesh. Okay, as soon as you paid the cash, no need to write the party name here. Now purchase account debtor to cash account being goods purchased for cash 10,000. And the last transaction is on credit sale. Sold goods to Akbar. So Akbar is a person, comes under personal account, and rule of the personal account is debit the receiver, credit the giver. So Akbar is the receiver because we are selling. Akbar account debtor to sales account 16,000 being goods sold on credit. Hope you enjoy today's class. Thank you.